Pokemon is a household name that's been a part of everything from trading cards to anime to Ryan Reynolds' IMDb page. We've all played a bit of Pokemon before, and at some point, we all wanted to be the very best. I remember those days. Pokemon Trainer is the OG silent protagonist that kicked off TV shows, movies, mobile games, and a super weird moral panic in the early 2000s. Remember that? Yeah. Pokemon Trainer is taking all that success straight over to Smash and looking strong in Ultimate right now too, may I add. Tweak already won a major tournament with the character, and a lot of the other notable PT players are doing great too. Nowadays, even Leffen thinks Pokemon Trainer is a powerful pick for battle. Hey. So, what makes Pokemon Trainer such a great character? Alright, three things. A great game plan, the Pokemon change mechanic, and the ability to have multiple playstyles. Today, we're going to be going over what it takes to understand this unique fighter, on your way to mastering three of the original 150 Pokemon. What's up, everybody? This is your guy, your friend, Keith Allen. If you want to connect with me, I would love to hear from you on my Instagram. All right, let's get started. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about the game plans first. In Smash, every character has a game plan. Pikachu wants to combo early on and pressure opponents off stage. Snake wants to zone out his opponents and push them into making bad decisions. Pac-Man wants to make his opponents so confused that they SD. But Pokemon Trainer, might have the strongest game plan of any character in Ultimate. Ultimate Pokemon Trainer might be the best combination character Nintendo has ever made. Unlike Melee, Zelda, and Sheik, it's not just about picking the strongest character and using them. Pokemon Trainer actually functions like a team of three Pokemon that need to work together. Just like in the games. Well, except that this time, no one told Pokemon Trainer that they could have six Pokemon. Oh, and that Charizard is the worst Pokemon, despite being the only fully evolved one. Sorry if I sound a little annoyed. Anyways, Pokemon Trainer's game plan is pretty simple, okay? First, you Squirtle to combo the opponent while they're at low percentages, then switch to Ivysaur to land smaller strings, winning neutral at mid percentages. Finally, KO the opponent with Charizard. This game plan works so well because each Pokemon is S tier at specific things. Squirtle's low percent combo game is one of the best in Ultimate. His down throw is a perfect combo throw that leads into pretty much any of his aerials. He's also pretty quick, and he has good frame data, so he's able to bait and punish opponents pretty well with his quick moves. Ivysaur is also great at putting their opponent at disadvantage thanks to his short strings. His up air in particular has huge hitbox that makes it great for juggling opponents and tech chasing them on platforms. He can even combo up airs into up airs. Neutral air has a long-lasting hitbox that makes it hard to punish, great for winning neutral. And his forward and down air are incredible edge guarding and ledge trapping tools. All of these things make Ivysaur great at mid percents, where you want to win neutral hard and land strong hits that put the opponent into kill percent. Ivysaur actually has some good kill options too, but if they aren't enough, then it's time for Charizard. Charizard's raw strength as a heavy character makes him the Pokemon for finishing the stock. His up throw and back air can kill very easily, my goodness, but he can also use forward air and up smash too. But the only reason this game plan works so well in the first place is because of their down special, Pokemon Change. So Pokemon's trainer down special, Pokemon Change, has surprising depth. On the surface, okay, Pokemon Change looks like nothing more than a character switch. In neutral, its use seems pretty simple. After you finish your string with Squirtle, you fast fall down, change to Ivysaur, and get ready to fight. Once you beat them up and knock them off stage with Ivy, you change to Charizard while they recover. Then, when you take the stock, you switch back to Squirtle while the opponent responds. Okay, so there's actually more to it than just that. Alright, for starters, Pokemon Change grants a short period of invincibility. That means that Pokemon Trainer can use it to keep their squad of dangerous animals out of danger. If an opponent is about to combo you into Oblivion or land a crucial kill move, you can just use Pokemon's Change invincibility frames to dodge the attack. Yeah. You know, there is some lag after the invincibility is done, so you might still get punished. So it's also important to note that you won't get invincibility frames for spamming it. So changing a bunch in a short time frame will get you punished too. But it is still super good. Hey, you can even use Pokemon Change in midair after using Ivysaur's up special. That means you can miss the ledge with Ivysaur's Vine, right? Then switch to Charizard, jump once, recovering to the ledge. And on top of all of that, you can even cancel out a lot of the move's lag by buffering another special move as the change is happening. After you hit down and B, you can immediately start inputting another special move that'll launch right after the change completes. You know, oftentimes the best thing to do is just pick the quickest, least committal special move, right? Essentially, you know, you want the move with the least in lag. For Squirtle and Charizard, it's their neutral special. For Ivysaur, it's his high special Razor Leaf, or his up special can be good too. Now, what happens if you're stuck on a character you don't like or you get knocked off of the game plan? Is PT just bad when that happens? Not really, because PT has tons of different playstyles. So while each Pokemon is best suited for a particular part of the game, they've got options that make them solid all around and just give them workable playstyles. For example, Squirtle doesn't have a lot of kill power. He's more of a combo character, right? But he still has reliable kill setups. He can forward tilt, chase down the opponent, jab block them, and hit them with the smash attack. Charizard isn't the best combo character, but he's still got some things to work with. His back throw can lead to a forward air, and his up tilt and down air, well, they can set up juggling opportunities. He's also not the best in neutral, but he does have some good hitboxes and options, like up smash, out of shield, and neutral air. Then there's Ivysaur, who's good at pretty much everything but recovering. Each Pokemon has a clear strength, and the whole team functions better together, but they can work alone if you switch your playstyle. Ivysaur's great hitboxes and frame data make him a good, pure, neutral character who can just control the stage and punish mistakes. Squirtle's speed combos and jab resets make him play a bit like Fox or other high-risk, high-reward species. Then there's Charizard, who plays like a heavy. He can survive through a lot and quickly equalize the game with an early kill or a good string. Just be careful about whiffy moves because he is combo food. The good Pokemon trainers know the game plan super well, and they know all the mechanics behind Pokemon change. The best Pokemon trainers know the individual strengths of the Pokemon and how to change their playstyle to suit them. That makes Pokemon Trainer one of the most versatile and tough-to-read characters in the game. You know, it's hard to learn how to use all those playstyles, but it's even tougher for opponents to learn how to beat them. That makes Pokemon Trainer one of the sickest teams you've ever seen, even if they definitely weren't EV training that Charizard. Hey, once again, this is your guy, your friend, Keith Allen, and I hope you enjoyed this video.